This principle should be used more often, especially in case you want to build an antenna yourself. Check out the interesting measurements and link tests. Radio frequency bands are being used more and more, leading to interference in amateur radio, broadcast, LoRa, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi frequency bands, for example. Intermodulation by neighboring radio services is often the root cause. In this case, the special properties of loop antennas are helping us. More about this on our playlist about antennas and wave propagation, which I have linked on the top right. Feel free to watch the videos. Today we are building, measuring and testing a 37 degrees delta loop. Before we start, I need to give you a hint. When it comes to PCBs, assembly or manufacturing parts, don't miss to visit the websites of PCBWay, the sponsor of this video. There are great offers and a community platform where makers are sharing their projects, and the contests are always exciting. You will find also our best projects there. Take the easy way with PCBWay. The following experiments are answering some practical questions that we have for the delta loop. Is the antenna easy to build? Can we really achieve 50 ohms impedance without a matching network? And above all, how does its performance relate to other antennas we know? We built the antenna for 866 MHz to compare it with a commercial rubber coil antenna, a homemade quarter wave monopole and a homemade round loop. The construction is consisting of sturdy 2 mm copper wire. Since the wire is relatively thick compared to the wavelength of 34.6 cm, we use the length factor A equal to 1.12 in our dimensioning tool. The concept works with 0.3 mm wire too, in that case a length factor A of 1.03 is appropriate. By the way, in an earlier video we are showing the dimensioning for many interesting frequency ranges in case you want to build the antenna for your own purpose. The assembly is really super simple. Just bend your wire according to the dimensioning and attach a 50 ohms connector. As you can see, I soldered the wires directly to an SMA connector without any matching network. I like that the antenna is flat. It takes up little space, for example, compared to a ground plane antenna where you always have dead studs. The nano VNA reflection measurement is showing exactly the desired resonance frequency. The VSWR is perfect at the center frequency and reflection losses correspondingly high. In other words, we are achieving exactly 50 ohms antenna impedance. We need to look at the wider frequency range to assess whether the antenna can reduce intermodulation. Although there is a dip below 866 MHz, lower frequencies are blocked out very well. That's very good, because a significant part of interfering radiation is on lower frequencies. However, we find 1, 2, 3, 4 dips indicating further resonance modes where the antenna receives signals. It's twice as many as with the round loop, which we examined on Electronics Unmasked. The delta loop's intermodulation suppression doesn't reach the circular loops. Now comes the semi-professional antenna test, which every hobbyist can carry out. You're just recording a series of received signal strengths over time to create statistics. In our case, these are LoRa RSSI values, which I recorded together with the measurements from my climate sensors. I'm recording the serial debugging interface of my LoRa weather server using a terminal program. One sensor is located on the balcony of the house, the other one is in a remote garage. I'm receiving data every 5 minutes, so I need 48 hours to record about 500 datasets for a proper statistic. From the data file, I can filter out the RSSI values using Excel. For evaluation, we are drawing the probability density of the received signals. It's basically telling us how often a certain received signal strength is occurring. The rubber coil antenna is receiving signals from sensor 2 between minus 115 and minus 95 dBm. Sensor 3 is delivering similar values, although its signal path is much shorter. However, it doesn't transmit so well, because its rubber coil antenna in the casing is losing about 10 dB compared to the other sensor's quarter wave monopole. The variance is different, because the signal path for sensor 3 depends on activities in the house, while for sensor 2 it's changing a bit due to the weather conditions. Now we are looking at the statistics for the delta loop. The mean signal strength is significantly higher than for the rubber coil, and in addition the variance is lower. Next, we compare the round loop antenna, showing signal strengths close to the delta loop and a slightly lower variance. By the way, there are two maxima, because I obstructed the wave propagation of sensor 2 with my body sitting at my desk for a long time. The quarter wave monopole's performance is better than the rubber coils, but it doesn't get anywhere close to the loops. This graph is showing the probability for signal strengths being above a certain level. The further the curve to the right, the better the quality of the radio channel. The loop's performance is significantly better than the commercial rubber coil, while the monopole antenna is somewhere in between. The first criterion for assessing a radio channel is the mean signal strength, which should be as high as possible. In our case, the radio propagation paths are the same, and this way we can compare the performance of antennas with that statistic. The second criterion is the standard deviation, which is a measure of the signal variance. It should be as small as possible. As you can see, some antennas are coping better than others with a volatile radio channel. Circular loop antennas are achieving the best results in that respect. The delta loop is easy to build, as it actually doesn't need a matching network, and it achieved the highest signal strength in our test. The round loop is better in terms of standard deviation and frequency selectivity, which can avoid intermodulation. We can achieve more reliable radio connections using loops compared to a rubber coil or a quarter wave monopole. It's definitely worth trying it. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.